I teach college writing at Seattle Central College in Seattle on Capitol Hill. And what I found most effective in order for me to give my students a good sense of control, developmental control, as they write, I like to show them patterns in the writing. So all good writing has some pattern, and hopefully the skill of the writer is such that you won't really be aware of the pattern. But let's say my first paper, we're going to look at a controversial issue which reasonable people can stand on either side. So there's really no right or wrong position. I call this pattern the position paper pattern. But before we do that, first we identify the controversy and we create a T-bar. You're familiar with the T-bar, the pro-con list. So I show my students that from a good pro-con list, this pattern, which I'll show you, is easy to control and develop. So let's say we're looking at the aid in dying debate. So let's just do a T-bar, for and against, or pro and con. So I help them, I want them to think about these pros and cons as possible subheadings or subtitles, which now I'm glad to see that MLA are using that in their sample paper. They call them subheadings and they italicize them to help the student and the reader organize the topic. So let's just take 4x4. So we'll do a 4x4 T-bar. Four good reasons to legalize aid in dying. We got choice. We have dignity, maintains dignity, relieves pain and suffering. Okay. And a quick note, pain is different from suffering. And then we have, they've got three, choice, dignity, relieves pain and suffering, and simply an option. Or just in case. Four good reasons to not legalize aid in dying would be this is a slippery slope. The slippery slope argument is quite common. Slippery slope to euthanasia in this case. Okay. Also, some people say it promotes suicide. Or just simply all we're doing is promoting suicide. Others say these patients are too depressed to make a rational decision. They're not in their right mind. Others might say it violates the Hippocratic Oath, so we'll put violates oath. Hope you start to see what I've done is sometimes all I have is just the term. Sometimes I put in the verb, but most times it's just the reason. So this way I help them, these can be subtitles or subheadings already. So I have a good T-bar. And then I show them this is a 5-point pattern. The first point is I want them, the operative verb is to engage the reader. So we want to engage the reader. So this is different than the typical pattern, introduction, three bodies of support, and a conclusion. That's a pattern, which is an effective pattern, but at this college level, students need to learn a little bit more sophisticated patterns. So we engage the reader. Two, just simply state the position. And this is a simple position statement. So the students could always keep their eyes on their position. Three, we argue directly for that position using a variety of strategies. And I show the students how to use different sources, like some parts of the Bill of Rights, for example. You argue directly. Four, this is the counter-argument part. Counter-argument's two parts. A, you yourself will fully and fairly present the objection. Present the objection or question. Second part of the counter-argument is to counter it. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Remember, this is not a conclusion. This is a call to action. So I try to impress upon my students that this pattern has what I like to call velocity. It has engages a reader. You state the position, you argue directly using reasons and strategies. You counter-argue, you take an objection, you present it, you counter it, and then they want to know, what do we do now? Where do we go from here? And then this is where you do the call to action. And I stress upon my students that throughout the argument for the position and even the counter and the call to action, they should move fluidly between three appeals or strategies: emotional, logical, and ethical. And most students are familiar with this: logos, ethos, pathos. So they have some training, some knowledge. I stress upon them that these three, not one is superior. So we have a good T-bar with possible subtitles, and all we have to do now is plug it in and the paper writes itself. And that'll be my next part, but right now you've got velocity, nothing's repeated, because in the old pattern, introduction, support, conclusion, in the conclusion you repeat yourself. Why? There's no velocity. What do you want the readers to think about, to do, or to feel? Engage the reader, state position, argue directly. This is the heart of your paper, and this is also a key part, because people, I tell them, and I'll wrap this up, this first part, is your main purpose is not to convince somebody of your position, whether side. Your main purpose is to be taken seriously. That's your purpose. Thank you.